Afternoon. So I'm Catherine Boromans from IFREMER. I work in the Deep Sea Lab as a biology and imagery engineer. And today I'm presenting the Deep Sea Spy system, or how to build a marine images annotation database from participative science. So just a brief overview of my presentation. I will begin with an introduction to give you the context of the project. Then I will describe each part of the system. So there is the annotation system part that we call Deep Sea Spy. Then the data management linked to the annotation system. And at the end, the query system part, which is called Deep Sea Spy Request. And I will finish giving you some perspective for the project. So, as you probably know, most of the current knowledge on deep sea environment is based on oceanographic missions that happens sporadically, punctually, and as a result, we don't have a lot of information about temporal trends on faunal communities of this environment. Since nearly a decade, observatories were deployed at different points on seafloor in the global ocean. So, for example, the MZO Azores Observatory was deployed in 2010 on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge in a hydrothermal vent site. And the Ocean Networks Canada Observatory was deployed in 2011 on the Juan de Fuca Ridge in the Pacific Ocean, also on a hydrothermal vent site. And these observatories have different instruments and one ecological module called TEMPO that hosts cameras which record at a certain frequency videos and throughout the year. So that allow long-term monitoring of these ecosystems. So with these high-frequency videos, scientists analyze the images, so they annotate them, and that give information about growth, reproduction, responses to changes of the environment, and so on. So they identify, they count, they measure, make observations about the species that are visible on the images. So here is an example of the Canadian Observatory. And here's a picture from the MZO Azores Observatory. So faunal communities are a bit different. So what about the imagery archive resulting from this high-frequency recording? So the two observatories generate nearly 800 video hours a year. So that means that since 2010, more than 5,000 video hours were recorded by the cameras. And knowing that we need 20 work hours to annotate one video hour, that means that we would need more than 11 years to annotate the present whole dataset. And this dataset is still growing. So the proceeding of such a big dataset is labor-intensive and very time-consuming for only a few researchers. So they had to find a solution, and they decided to engage citizens in this initial analysis of images and for the annotation. So that's the origin of the Deep Sea Spy project. So the idea is to develop a citizen science project. It was initiated by the Envri Plus project. So we have two sources of video, so the one from Canada and from the Azores. From videos, we have a program to extract and name the images automatically. Then images are uploaded in an online interface for annotation. And linked to this online interface, we have a project website in order to give information to the general public about the scientific context and how the result will help. The results will help to improve knowledge about deep sea environment. And then behind the annotation system, we have a data management organization. And at the end, we have developed an interface dedicated to scientists for data mining. So I will go in details of each part of this system. So first, the annotation part. So Deep Sea Spy, it's a web-based software developed for manual processing, and it is meant to be a fun and engaging interface, so to stir up interest of citizen for deep sea ecosystem. So it is available online, on internet. This is built as a game and is organized by a mission, game mission. So there is a limitation in time for the annotation of a certain data set of images. There is a tutorial for to explain how to correctly annotate images. There is a system of levels and virtual rewards for encouraging participants. And all the data are stored in Pixels unit. So this is the look of the interface. Okay. So the image becomes randomly for the user. User has some different tools available. So he has a list of species to annotate with some explanation on how to annotate, because depending on the organism, they have to just point or measure or draw polygons. And other tools, he can zoom in and zoom out, put a grid and add comments. And so this application is available on the deepseaspy.com website. So the data generated by this system concern citizen science and imagery. We have information about users, their levels in their level in the game, about images, so the position, the date, the observatory it comes from, and about annotation themselves. And all the data of Deep Sea Spy are loaded in an IFRMER central database in order to have a minimum of standardization. So for example, we use taxonomic references and also parameters from CDataNet. So we had to create a new parameter codes for this purpose, because we had to specially indicate that we are measuring information on digital object and not on specimen in samples. So LastPass is about the data mining interface. It's a quite recent development and still needs still further development. So it is a tool dedicated to scientists, because they need to search and to explore the data generated by Deep Sea Spy. So they can select their data by mission, by observatory, by species, and there is a complex temporal criteria for to extract the data. So the data are exported in a file, and afterwards they can import it in R or other software for further statistical analysis. So just to, sorry for the problem for displaying. Some perspective for the project. So the main objective of the project was to build a solid database of annotation in order to improve algorithms for automatic detection of organisms in using machine learning approaches. So the database is the beginning. So we need a bigger database to achieve this. But this is our main goal. We also would like to materialize the system to generalize it with other scientific discipline, because the problem is the same also for coastal zone studies or in fisheries, where they use imagery for studies. We would like to use Elasticsearch technology for the deep sea spy request part of the system to improve performances and also visualization and exploration of the data. And last but not least, maybe a dream for the moment, but it would be probably extremely useful for the imagery community to move towards a unique data management infrastructure for that kind of data. So this is, of course, teamwork. So I would like to thank all the colleagues who participated to this project, and thank you all for your attention. Thank you.